Hello everyone, my name is Josh LeVine and I am an Automation Solutions Architect at Palo Alto Networks working on the product Cortex XSOAR, formerly known as Demisto. And today I'm going to be giving you a walkthrough on how to create an external dynamic list using threat intelligence that is hosted on XSOAR 8 and then served to a Palo Alto Networks firewall running PAN-OS. To begin with, I'm going to go over to my Cortex XSOAR 8 platform, and I am going to create an external dynamic list. To do this, there's a number of steps that you need to take. First, you have to have identified the data that you want to share out through an external dynamic list in XSOAR. In this case, I've only got one feed coming in, and I'm going to tie that to the specific integration instance that I've got configured, in this case, the abuse.ch feed. And this is going to serve as my query for the external dynamic list for data that's going to be shared externally. So now that I know what I want to share, I'm going to go over to my settings page, and I'm going to configure an instance of the generic export indicator service. Now this service can be used to serve data up in a variety of formats, but in this case, I'm only focused on one. And I'm going to name this abuse.ch. You can assign a random port. In this case, it doesn't really matter because we're going to be accessing this through HTTPS. I'm going to click on Advanced Settings, and I'm going to take that query that I showed over in the Threat Intel page, paste it into the integration configuration, and I'm going to leave the default format selected, which is PAN-OS text, default refresh rate, and you can configure this to whatever your organization requires, but for this demo, I'm going to leave it relatively simple. I'm going to do a quick test just to make sure everything works. And once that comes back, I'm going to go ahead and click on close. So everything tested fine. I'm going to save that integration instance, and we can verify that that's configured in our instance here. As you can see, the instance named WCH is present. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to configure the username and password that I want to use to access this EDL. Now, this configuration option is global for all EDLs, but you can specify it individually in the generic export indicators instance that I configured previously. In this case, I'm only going to host one instance, so I'm just going to leave it pretty simple. And with that configuration saved, I'm going to move over to my terminal window. And the first thing I'm going to do is test to make sure that this external dynamic list works. It's important to note that the prefix EDL dash is appended to the URL itself, and that you can take from your XSOAR instance that you can see right here at the top of my Firefox browser. This will be changing with XSOAR 8.2. EDL dash will be changed to EXT dash. And then the rest of the URL is specified in the generic export indicator service documentation that can be seen when you're configuring the integration instance in XSOAR itself. So I'm going to launch this test. You can see everything came back successfully. I've got a list of IP addresses produced by the abuse.ch data feed. So the next thing I'm going to do is run a command to do a little command line kung fu to parse out the certificates that are associated with my particular XSOAR 8 hosted instance. This is needed so that you can import the certificate profile into the PAN-OS firewall. Run this command. Now that it's complete, we can see we have four different certificates that are produced. This is the entire certificate chain pointing to the Cortex-SA-XSOAR-15 subdomain on the XSOAR 8 hosted servers. With that, I'm going to import these into my firewall. So from the Devices tab in your firewall, navigate over to Certificates, click on Import, and make sure to change the format to PEM. I'm going to browse and select each certificate. And in this case, I'm just going to name them Demo Cert 1, 2, 3, and 4 for simplicity's sake. There we go, Certificate 2. And as I'm importing these, you'll notice that it stack these in a hierarchical fashion based on where they reside in the certificate chain. And import the final certificate. Now we've got all four imported into the firewall. I'm going to go ahead and create a certificate profile. And in this case, I'm just going to name it demo. I'm going to add each CA certificate. So what you're going to notice is that one of these does not show up, one of the certificates that you imported, and that's because it is not a CA cert. So I'm just going to add the three CA certs that we imported into this certificate profile. With that done, I'm going to go ahead and create the external dynamic list object. So on the objects tab, navigate over to external dynamic lists. And for this, you're going to need the full URL for your EDL. So I'm going to navigate over to my terminal again, pull up the command that I ran to for the curl test. Take that over, go ahead and add an external dynamic list. This will just be called demo. Fill in the URL, select the certificate profile that we just created. For client authentication, this is going to be the credentials that you filled in within XSOAR at the start of this demo. In this case, test user. Do not click test source URL because for HTTPS URLs, that will fail. That is expected behavior in the firewall. So I'm going to go ahead and hit OK. And one important thing to note, a step that will bite you if you forget to do it, I'm going to navigate over to my policies tab and I'm going to update my demo policy, security policy that I've created, because that EDL needs to be associated with a security policy rule before it will function. So I've selected my EDL object. I'm going to hit OK. And I'm going to perform my commit. And with that commit complete, we can go ahead and validate that the external dynamic list is functioning. So I'm going to go ahead and click into the demo EDL and look over at the list entries. And as you can see, all the IP addresses from that external dynamic list that's hosted in XSOAR 8 have populated into the firewall. Now it's important to remember that if you see that nothing's populating here, make sure that the EDL is associated with a security policy. Otherwise, by default, the firewall will not pull down that EDL content. Just an important troubleshooting step to remember. And with that, that concludes this demo. I hope you have found it useful, and please let me know if there's any other content that you would like to see. Thank you.